change. Everyone wants a change, but not just any change, but a change that brings satisfaction, a change of possibilities, a change that brings hope to our great continent, Africa. Do you know you are the change? Yes, we are the change. And with a lift of our chin and a bit of a grin, we can make that positive change. We can build the infrastructure that Mother Africa needs. We can boldly say, we are the sons and daughters of Africa. Africa Business Arena, where African business lives.
Good afternoon, viewers. My name is Derek Kofi Boateng, a training consultant for Global Institute of Resource Development. Now, this program is IdeaStream, a program initiated and empowered by Global Institute of Resource Development, GED Ghana. It's a program designed to educate you on various business topics to enhance your business growth. Now, today, I want us to look at an important topic which I believe that every business owner, every accountant, every CEO should know. And that's how to select a computerized accounting system. Simply, how to select a financial management system. Now, you agree with me that we've moved from the manual way of keeping records for businesses to the computerized way of doing that. That's the use of computers in doing accounting or in recording accounting transactions. Now, I want us to look at the best way that you can select an accounting software for your organization, for your business, for your small shops, and then any other industry that you find yourself. Before we start, I want us to first look at what an accounting software is, or somebody say what a financial management software is. Now, a financial management software is simply a class of computer program that help business transactions. Or somebody will say it is an application software that help businesses to organize their transactions and at the end of the day to generate various forms of reports. The report includes the financial statement, it includes the income statement, the balance sheet. Now we call it the statement of financial position and cash flow and other business report that you know of. Now, again, it's not enough for you to know the definition of accounting software for you to select a software package for your business. You should understand the importance of these softwares, why you need to have these softwares in place in your organization. And the first point that you have over here is accuracy. Now, this software helps in the way to increase your accuracy because it eliminates a lot of errors. You once again agree with me that the manual way most times brings up a lot of human errors. But with the use of a computer system or any software application, it eliminates a lot of human errors because you are dealing with computers. Not only that, the next important thing is that speed. It enhances speed. Now, you agree with me that in the process of you preparing an account, if you're an accountant and if you've prepared an account before, or if even recorded a transaction in your normal shop before, you agree with me that in the process of you recording those transactions, most times it delays times, it buys time. But the use of this accounting software enables you to work faster. In fact, it works faster than the human brain, as somebody would put it. So therefore, with accuracy and speed, you can therefore minimize cost when you are using this accounting software. So the next important part of it is that it eliminates a lot of cost. A lot of cost. Now, the benefit of using this accounting software is that you eliminate a lot of cost. Okay, now let's say the use of an accounting software program allows each member of an accounting department to do more in a given time. That's potentially meaning that a smaller team will be needed, and therefore that reduces the payroll or the number of people that you should pay. So first of all, one of the important aspects of it that you should know is that it's cut down cost, because you will not need more than 3 or 4 people doing the same work. You need less people doing the work with accuracy and speed. Another important aspect of it is the report side. Let's say, for instance, a manager is going for a meeting, he needs a financial statement. Let's say the cash flow in 2 hours before the meeting. With the manual way, it will take a lot of time before you can produce those reports or that report. But with the system, most accounting software is designed in such a way that after you're able to enter transaction correctly, it automatically processes the report for you. So you don't need to struggle in balancing figures and all that. The system will automatically generate all that report for you, which make it very, very important. Very, very important. Lastly, for the benefits, is the tax. Now, it helps you to compute complicated aspect of tax, make it very easy for you to compute it using the softwares. Now, a typical example is, let's say, now filing a business tax can be complex, as we say, and requiring you to keep close track of all your business transactions. Now, we say accounting software helps to make this process easier by ensuring that all of your business financial details are in one place. So therefore, you don't need to go and then get a sales receipt to track the VAT that you collected from behalf of the GRA, or go and take a lot of record. The system have all those informations at one place that you need to just go there and print the report out. This is Global East of Resource Development, IdeaStream. I believe you are enjoying our lesson for today. It is how to select an accounting software program. There are so many types of accounting software package that we have. Now, you don't just go to the marketplace and choose an accounting software, or you don't just call somebody you know who are using accounting software and ask him which accounting software should I use. You need to understand what an accounting software is. You need to understand the importance. You need to understand the reason why you should go in for a particular software. And before you can do that, understand the types of softwares that you have. The first type of software that I know you might be familiar with is the spreadsheet. These are Microsoft Excel or the Google spreadsheet. This program allows you to list all your expenses, your incomes, in a more simple way. So generally, we say only a simple business should rely solely on a spreadsheet to handle accounting. For most other spreadsheet usually complement other accounting processes. So the first type of accounting software that we have is a spreadsheet. Now, the next type that we have is what we call the commercial accounting software. And I believe most people are familiar again with that one as well. I believe you've heard about the QuickBooks, the Tally, PL9, you've heard about the Sage 50, and then the rest. These are software designed by professionals for people who are in the small to the medium size business industry. So if your business is within the SME, then this software is most times recommended for you. Despite the fact that we have the various forms that you should, or the various things that you should consider before you even select it, which will come to that later. Now, commercial accounting software often include graphs that summarize data, as well as reports that provide a picture of a business health. Each type of commercial accounting software have a strength and weakness. So as I said, each of these accounting software that I did mention earlier on have strength, have their weakness. You should know the industry that you are, the kind of service that you provide, the product that you sell to your client before you select any of the commercial accounting package that we have. The next important type that we have as well is the enterprise. Now, these are softwares, again, designed for people in the large industries who have a lot of operation that goes on. Now, we say that accounting software for larger enterprise often integrate accounting with other services provided by the software, such as workflow management, business intelligence and project planning. So the enterprise structure most times have other business component, or what we say, other business department, their workflow integrated in the software. So you have one software, that same software, you have the HR using it, you have the accountant using it, you have the procurement department using it, you have the project management using it, and all other departments using the same software. Example is the SAP, the SAP, the Oracle, the ERP, other softwares, and the rest. Now, the next type of software that we have is what we call the customized software. Most companies would like to have their own software, to own the software. So in this case, they will bring an IT expert to come in to develop a customized software for them that only the organization or their business have that software. So you say in another situation, a business such as the integrated solution group, for example, create a custom software because there are no commercial accounting program that meet their need. So if you realize that there is no accounting software package that meets your business need, then I recommend that you can go in for the customized softwares. Again, you are watching IdeaStream. This is Global Institute of Resource Development, a program that is designed to help our electronic viewers educate them more and more on business issues. Now to the main topic for the day. Don't forget that we've considered what an accounting software is, or what a financial management software is. We've considered the importance of those softwares, and now, and the types of those softwares, and now let's look at how to select an accounting software for your business. I mean your business. Then when? Now, when do one consider selecting or buying accounting software? The first one you should know before you go in to buy an accounting software or to select an accounting software package for your business, you should know these basic steps. And these basic reasons should be the baseline for which you are selecting an accounting software. Don't forget, don't go to your friend. Don't buy a software because your competitor is using that same software. Let an expert come in and help you. But these basic steps will educate you on how to select an accounting software, or the reason why you should select those accounting software. Now, the first point is when you have no accounting software. Despite the fact that businesses have moved from the manual way of keeping records to the computerized way, doesn't mean everybody have moved. As we always say in change management, change is a process and not an event. So therefore, I know there are people who are yet considering using accounting software. Now, if you don't have an accounting software, I would advise you to get an accounting software. So it should be the first reason why you want to use an accounting software. The next important reason is that when you recognize that your current system is unable to cope with the information needs of your business. For instance, you've changed your first delivery only services. Now you've planned adding some product to it. The software you were using was most efficient for a service company, but now you have the two, both service and products. You ask yourself, is the software you're using going to help you? If that software is unable to cope with the information needs of your business, then I will recommend that you change the software or you buy a new accounting software. The third point is when you realize that your business process have changed. Now, once your business process changed, then I would advise you that you need to consider a new accounting software. If you are not, or if you are using it, you need to also assess whether that software will be able to work effectively or efficiently for you. The last but not the least is when you recognize that the current software you are using can no longer work on a newer platform or operating platform. Then the need arises for you to change the software or buy a new software. Don't forget, it's not enough to understand softwares. It's not enough for you to know the types, the importance of it, but how to select it, the reason why you should select it. Now, that alone is also not enough. Before selecting the accounting package, after knowing the reasons why you should change your software, you should involve some key people. So we say you should involve the right people to help you select your accounting software or the accounting package that you want to use. So we say that first of all, you should involve system users. The system users will help you to know the challenges that you are facing with the current accounting software, and then they can also help in recommending. But not alone the system users, you can also involve the system managers. These are people who manage the system, the IT guys in your organization, or a friend who specializes in this field. That's accounting software package. They can help you select a good accounting package for your business. The last but not the least people that you should involve before you select an accounting software package or the financial management software, any of them, is a system customers. Now, these are simply people who have had a branch of the accounting software, who have one use any of the accounting software you are considering choosing for your business. As I said earlier on, don't forget, there have been a move from the manual way of doing things to the computerized way, and therefore I highly recommend that every business have an accounting software package for its operations. If you are in a medium-sized business or what we call the SMEs, then I would recommend the commercial software. If you are a big enterprise, the mining firms, the multinational companies, then I would recommend the enterprise software. If you can also afford and design your own software, then you fall in the category of those of them who use the customized accounting software. Now, before we end today's lesson, let's look at the last important aspect of how to select or when to select a computerized accounting software, and that's what we call define the challenge. Now, you should be able to know the reason why specifically you want to leave the current software that you are using, or you want to buy an accounting software. I believe this is one of the core functions of the managers, and then these are the responsibilities and duties of the managers of the business owner, the accountants, the sales, all other managers in the organization should help with this exercise. So with this exercise, we say that first of all, make a list of all your challenges. So make sure that you state clearly all the current challenges that you are facing with the current system or within your organization. So under it, we have where in the current system are you experiencing the highest productivity loss or the highest number of errors. If that is your reason, you should be able to define it and answer it before you move on. You should be able to also as well know that what information or report are being requested that the current software cannot deliver. So if you recognize or if you realize that there is a report that the current system is not able to give you, then you should be able to define this challenge and answer it, and it will help you in selecting the accounting software. So the next set of questions you can ask yourself in this exercise is that, are you experiencing a poor security and data validation controls? Now, every software should be able to have a strong security controls, a very strong security control. There should be a password assigned to the software that you're using, so no third person can come in and manipulate your figures. This exercise is very important. Now, after listing the challenges, the next important thing that you should do is to make a list of what you would like to do but unable to do if the current software that you're using. So if you are using accounting software, or if you are not even using, make a list of what you would like to do but you are not able to do. In other words, the report that you want to generate but you can't generate. This exercise is very important. So I'll once again, before we end today's episode, I'll once again go through. Define the challenges, make a list of all the challenges, and then you can answer some of the questions like, where in the current system are you experiencing the highest productivity loss or the highest number of errors? what information reports are being requested that the current software cannot deliver, where in the system are you experiencing a poor security and validation controls. If you can answer these questions well and list what you like to do, I believe you are at the point of helping your business grow or even selecting a better software for your company. I believe today's lesson will be more educative. We talk about how to select an accounting software, what we call the financial management software. We talk about what the financial management software is. We said a financial management software is a computer program that enables businesses to enter transactions and generate the various reports that they need for their business operations. We talk about the importance of an accounting software, the reason why you should have accounting software in your business. We said the reason, the first point is because of accuracy, the second because of speed, because of cost, because the report it generates, and because it easily helps you to complete your tax or file your tax. We talk about the types of accounting software that we have. We talk about a spreadsheet, which I believe that you are familiar with that one. We talk about the commercial softwares, the QuickBooks, the Sage, the Tally, and all those falls into the commercial software. These are softwares designed by professionals, but for small and medium-sized businesses. We talk about the enterprise type of software where big operations, companies, VIT, big operations are recommended to use such softwares. And lastly, for the type, I talk about the customized software where it is basically designed to meet the needs of your organization, only the needs of your organization. Now, from there, we moved on to how to select an accounting software. We said that before you do that, involve the system users, the system manager, the system customers, and then define the challenge. The exercise I believe you should do now is to define the challenge. Sit down, take a pen, list the challenges that will be confronting you pertaining to the accounting and the financial records. You can ask the basic question that we talked about. You can also make a list of what you could like to do but unable to do. And with this exercise, I believe that you can be able to choose an appropriate software for your organization. Don't buy a software because a friend is using that same software, or don't buy a software, choose a software because your competitors are using it. Sit down, do this exercise, and I believe at the end you'll be able to know the kind of software that works for you. Now, at Global Institute of Resource Development, we have a special executive short courses that we do, and one of them is in computer accounting software. Now, you get an opportunity to learn three major softwares, how to use them, and with this, you can select the software that you need. I believe it's a program that has benefited thousands of people over the past 5 years that we started. Thank you for joining us for today's episode of IdeaStream. As I said earlier on, IdeaStream is empowered and initiated by Global Institute of Resource Development, an organization in Ghana that is into training and consultancy services. Thank you. Have a good afternoon. Good afternoon.